In this video, I'm going to show you how to easily install Raspberry OS on your Raspberry Pi, just in a few steps. Also, this video is part of a mini-series that will show you how to create your fully functioning Foundry VTT on your Raspberry Pi. So, if you're a fan of Foundry, online D&D, any kind of online tabletop gaming, please do check out my future videos. Hi there, it's we. If you're looking for a tutorial on how to easily install Raspberry OS on your Raspberry Pi, look no further. This video will guide you through it. We'll go through some basics, some advanced settings, and we will be accessing your Raspberry Pi remotely. So we don't need stuff like display and keyboard connected to our Raspberry Pi. With that said, let's dive into it.
So, first things first, what do we need? The bare minimum, obviously, it's a Raspberry Pi. Me personally, I've got this Raspberry Pi 3B Plus model. It was lying around my office for some time now, so I figured let's try this one. This model got 1 GB of memory and still works pretty fine. So just for comparison, today's Raspberry Pi 4 has got up to 8 GB of RAM and basically is newer and better in every way. But the problem is there's shortage of chips and I'm waiting for mine for like half a year and it still has not been delivered. So actually you don't need this fancy casing, but I've already got it, so yeah. The next thing you need is power supply. Next you need your micro SD card reader. I've got this cheap USB SD card reader and it works fine for years now. Obviously you need your PC or laptop for setup of the SD card. The last thing you need is Wi-Fi or any other kind of network at your home. That's it. You really don't need anything else. So let's get to work. The first thing you need to do is to go to this webpage, www.raspberrypi.com/software. Scroll a little bit down and download Raspberry Pi Imager. You will find all of the links below this video so you can easily grab them. I'm showing you this on Windows PC, but I'm sure Apple and Linux users can follow. So download, install and launch Raspberry Pi Imager. Put your SD card in your computer using your card reader. I recommend to use card with size of at least 16 GB. After launching Raspberry Pi Imager, you choose operating system. Most common and recommended is this option of Raspberry Pi OS, but it needs to be said, it's not always the best option. In the past, I found a few reasons not to install this recommended version of OS. For instance, I prefer to install 64-bit version of this OS, because 32-bit versions sometimes run into issues with other programs like GC meeting server or Node.js server I've used in Foundry Docker image. So choose whichever you like. For this tutorial, I'll continue with the 64-bit version of Raspberry Pi OS. Next, we need to choose storage. It's our SD card. Here are the advanced options. In the past, I just call them hidden options because in older version of Raspberry Pi Imager, you could only access them after pressing Ctrl+Shift+X on PC or Cmd+Shift+X on Mac. It was ridiculous to hide these options from users, but hey, what can you do? So this window will pop up and you can set a few more things, like disable overscan. This is something to do with old screens that needed to compensate for problems with visibility on the outer edges of the screen, so I don't really need it today. Hostname, I like something shorter, let's say pi.local. Enable SSH, definitely yes. I like to set up my Raspberry headlessly. I don't want to attach my monitor, keyboard or anything else to Raspberry. So SSH access is enough. Set password, use something at least little secure. But don't worry, in future videos we'll secure our Raspberry Pi with SSH keys for authentication and then fortify it with two-factor authentication. Configure Wi-Fi. Yep, I want my Raspberry Pi to connect to Wi-Fi in my house, so I'll paste my SSID and password which I have prepared. And choose your country code. This country settings ensures that your device will only enable Wi-Fi radio settings that conform with the country's official regulatory laws. Set locale. I live in Europe, so I'll choose Prague and US keyboard layout. And I'll skip first run wizard as I want to start up my Raspberry and connect to it via SSH. Don't want to hang on some kind of wizard. The rest is pretty self-explanatory, and this enable telemetry checkbox just gives the creators of Raspberry Pi Imager information about which of the OSs are most popular, so disable it if you want. I don't need to do that. I'm glad that they put their efforts to build this for us. So those are the advanced options, which needed to be hidden in the past. Yeah, I think there's nothing advanced about these options. I would just call it basic options. And hit write. Now we need to wait a few minutes. As I'm master of the mystic arts, I'll just speed up time not to waste yours. Okay, it's finished. So let's eject this SD card and put it into our Raspberry Pi. If you followed me step by step, all you need to do now is just power up your Raspberry Pi and you should be able to connect to it from your computer. For this purpose, we can use Putty on PC or Vanilla Terminal on macOS or Linux. To connect to our Raspberry Pi, hostname should be enough. Alternatively, you can find IP address of your Raspberry Pi based on your actual network setup. So I'll just put in pi.local, it's the hostname you put in the advanced options. Use your credentials. And there you have it. In just a few steps, you can set up Raspberry Pi headlessly. That's how simple it is.
That's it. If this video helped you in any way, please leave a comment, hit that like button. It's the only way I will know that I need to make more of these videos. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.